Hello friends, hope all is well on your end. My name is Flip Awesome Aguilera and I am one of the founders of the Self-Defense Academy right here in Colorado Springs. So let me tell you a little bit about my story and what got me here. In 2019, I began my Jujutsu journey after 10 years, that's right, 10 years of it calling me. When I used to mountain bike race, there was a school called the Valente Brothers Self-Defense Academy that was across the street from one of the places I used to train at. And for 10 years, I drove by that place saying, you know what? I should walk in there and see what that's all about. You know, I was a personal trainer, and as a personal trainer, you want to experiment with different types of movement modalities to see how they work, what it does to the body. And, you know, I've done bodybuilding, I've done mountain biking, I've done dragon boating, I've done marathons, I've done Spartan races, I've done all these types of things. And that was still one of the things that was calling me, that I was still telling myself, maybe next time, maybe next time. In October of 2019, I finally walked into that building. And in just walking into the building, the disappointment that I felt for not doing it 10 years earlier was extremely palpable. But then I had the thought, the best time to plant a tree was 20 years ago. The next best time is right now. So I walked up the stairs of the Valente Brothers Academy, met some of the people there, and after taking my first class, was instantly hooked and thought to myself, how am I going to make this a part of my life every day? In February of 2020, I came here to Colorado Springs a few months before I was set to move here. So we came here to try to find a place to land because we knew we were going to move here in July of 2020, but we still had no place to actually bring the car to. You know, we had no GPS address to come to. So we came for a week in February, and that week I probably went to about 8 schools. And what I quickly realized was all the schools here in Colorado Springs are teaching the sport of Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, which, you know, it makes sense with the popularity of combat sports like the UFC and all of that. But the experience that I was having in Miami was one where the philosophy was just as important as learning how to defend yourself. And let's point out that whole thing on learning how to defend yourself, because a sport is not the same thing as defending yourself. Because you see, sports always happen under certain rules and guidelines. So when you decide to compete in a sport, what you're effectively doing is becoming a specialist within the set of rules and guidelines. But what I was practicing was self-defense. And in the street, none of those rules and guidelines apply. So after going to the schools and, you know, feeling a little bit of desperation, when I got back to Miami, which is where the Valente Brothers are headquartered, I spoke to one of the brothers and said, do you guys know anybody in that area? You know, what am I going to do? Because I like this whole philosophical history, how a move has evolved and adapted through the centuries or the decades or whatever the case may be. And the Valente brothers, who are royalty in the jiu-jitsu world, everybody knows who they are because they learn directly from Grandmaster Elio Gracie, and their father was also a Grandmaster, was also called Pedro Valente. So Guy looked at me in the face and said, why don't you start it? And I was a white belt at the time, and I just looked at him and be like, start what? I just started my journey. How am I gonna teach people this thing? Now, remember, I was a personal trainer. I've been doing all types of movement, and Guy knows that about me, and he looked at me and said, we believe you can do it. So we all know what happened in March of 2020, before I had the chance to move to Colorado Springs. And that almost derailed the whole program of coming to move here. But we had been saving for 5 years. We were doing the things we were supposed to do so that we can get here. So when July finally came around, my wife and I looked at each other and said, you know what, we've been planning for this, let's do it. Now, moving cross-country during a pandemic and being part of a profession where you need to actually meet people and be in close quarters with people, I'm sure we can all understand that COVID made that very difficult. So I had to do a few things to see what stuck, right? So I created all these events that are community building events. I work at Garden of the Gods as a wellness instructor over there. But my heart belongs with Jiu-Jitsu for self-defense. So I think it's finally time for me to start focusing on what I need to focus on. And just so that you know what it is we're trying to create, we have a quote here on our wall, and this is my garage. And funny enough, the Gracie family, when they moved to the United States, also started in a garage. So this is many great things, as we know, begin in garages with great intentions and great ability to want to make fantastic things happen. But let's get back to this quote. So the culture we are trying to build here in Colorado Springs is based around this quote. And it says, self-defense is not just a set of techniques. It's a state of mind. And it begins with the belief that you're worth defending. So that's what we're trying to create here with the Self-Defense Academy in Colorado Springs. And we love your help to make it a reality. Thank you very much for your time and attention. I look forward to connecting with you all. Have a good one.